You may not believe me when I say this, but setting up unique and engaging stream alerts for when someone supports your stream with a follow or a donation can go a long way to not just thanking that person, but also when used right, you can sometimes triple or even quadruple the revenue your stream is making. It could be as simple as setting up text-to-speech like I'm going to show you how to do today, or go a little bit fancier and set up unique variations depending on how much someone were to donate, which we're also going to be covering today. That's right, we're going to make you a Streamlabs alert box master and get your stream growing faster and more profitable. Let's go. Hey, I'm Eljay with streamteam.com. I'm also a variety streamer over at twitch.tv/LJM_. There's a link in the description to that if you want to check me out while I'm live. There's also a link to streamscheme.com, a place with over 600 guides for all things streaming and content creator alike. Go check it out. If there's not something covered on the channel, you guys know where it'll be, streamsteam.com. Today, I'm going to be showing you guys how to set up follower, bit, subscriber, and donation alerts inside Streamlabs alert box. I'm going to be showing you how to set up text-to-speech variations, so if people do different things, different alerts play. And most importantly, I'm going to be giving you some tips about how I've used the alert box to create a more profitable stream. That said, today I won't be showing you guys how to make custom animations for your alerts. This is entirely alert box and how it works. If you want to get custom animations, that's going to be another video coming soon. In the meantime though, if you just want one click and to have every single alert you're going to need set up, then why don't you go check out our sponsor of today's video, Own.TV. Own.TV are your one-stop shop for all things streaming related. Seriously, if you need a new overlay, you need sound alerts, you need a full alert pack, go check them out. They're linked in the description. They have everything. And I wasn't lying when I said it's one-click install. They've put a lot of work into making this as easy as possible for you guys. Massive thank you to Own.TV. If you want to support us, guys, go and support them with the link in the description because it allows us to keep making videos like this. Before we get into all the fun and fancy stuff that allows you guys to grow faster and to have a more profitable stream, which we will be covering at the end of this video, we have to first cover the basics of what an alert box is and how it works. For alerts to even show up inside Streamlabs, first you need to add an alert box. So what you're going to do is you're going to head to your sources. You're going to click this little plus button here and you're going to click add alert box to your scene. This alert box needs to be in every single scene if you want the alerts to actually show up. If you open it up and you hit the test button, you'll see Streamlabs has a default alert built into it or whatever alerts you're currently using. This is great for starting out, but we want to get a bit fancy. Different actions that a user takes to support your stream have different alerts behind them, such as followers, subscribers, bits, normal PayPal donations, and even merch, but we're not going to look at the merch today. The only important thing to say here is if you're going to set up donation alerts, it is a lot easier if you set up the donation alerts using the Streamlabs donation platform. It's essentially connecting your PayPal and being good to go from there. But quick tip, please make a business PayPal. If you don't have a business PayPal, people are going to get your entire full name and everything about you. Please protect yourself. I've seen too many streamers do this. When you add an alert box, it's going to set a default width and height. If you need to change that, you can do it later, but for now, we're going to leave it as is. I mentioned before all the different ways someone can support, but you can also see a full list of them here. When you click on one of them, the settings will open and you'll be able to change things. However, I really prefer doing all of my work in the Streamlabs website dashboard because I feel like I don't have to click save as much and a less goes wrong. So we're going to jump over to streamlabs.com and do it all over there. Click the alert box once you're at streamlabs.com, and I want you to click manage themes in the top right. If you already have a bunch of alerts set up and you want to mess around and follow along with this video, but you're worried about breaking something, you can actually create a new widget theme, click use on it, make sure it is active, and hit save. Now you're all set up to play around and do whatever you want without breaking your current alerts. Just make sure before you go live, you switch your alerts back to the old ones, or if you're happy with it, you don't need to do that. Head back to the alert box and select the follows section. We can edit our default alert here. I do think you should keep Streamlabs app open as well while you're doing this because you'll need to be able to click test. And if you don't have it open, you won't see the test. And there's no point changing a heap of stuff if you have no idea if it actually works. First things first, you're going to want to select your media, the imagery that is going to appear when someone follows or whatever it is. For me, I have this little version of myself popping up and doing a wave and a thank you. And if you guys want to make that, I'm going to cover it in a video soon, but let me know in the comments if it's actually something you care about. So I go down to the image tab, click this little select image button. There are some default options. So if you want to, you can just go with one of those for now. But I'm going to go over to the upload section and I will upload or select the GIF I want to use. Now I'm saying GIF here because I think a lot of you guys are more familiar with that format. However, if you can get it as a .webm, that is a much better option. You see, webms are just less intensive on your computers and the overall system. If the GIF, image, or webm doesn't have audio, then below that is the sound file. You'll pick this as well the same way, and the volume of that is below the sound upload section here. At this point, scroll down to the bottom to where you find this section, hit save, and then hit save again, and then hit save again. Why am I doing this? Well, I don't want to lose any of my work, and I found that sometimes it can be a little bit glitchy because there's the dashboard you've got open on your Streamlabs app and then the dashboard in the website. The next step is to set the message that goes off when someone follows. This is the little bit of text next to it. You'll see here I have a curly bracket and then the name, meaning the person's name, will appear. The layout at the top will show where my text appears in relation to my image and or GIF. If I change the layout and hit save, you can see the text will appear under it, on top of it, or to the side of it. I'm going to leave mine to the side for now because it just fits the style of the image I'm using. Try and play with it and find what fits your image. Hit save again because I just don't want you guys to lose your work. Please keep hitting save. Now you're going to want to set up your alert animation. This is how it's going to appear when someone follows. I have mine set to fade in and then fade out for this particular one, but I have other bit alerts that slide in from the left, play, and then slide out again the same way. You also have your text animation. This is what your text does. Most people set this to wiggle, but I personally prefer to leave it as none for my style of alerts. If you want to edit how your text looks, you'll open this drop down here. Size is obviously the size of your text. Weight is your thickness. Font drop down lets you pick the font family. Text color is the overall color, and text highlight is the important parts, like the username of the person who just followed. Don't forget to hit save again, and then we're going to set up our alert duration and the text delay. The alert duration really should be set to how long your animation plays for. Or if your animation is very short, like 2 seconds, set it to 7 or 8 seconds so it loops. Just be careful with long audio sources because those can kind of throw this out. Try and match your audio source with your animation. Text delay is how long after the alert starts before your text comes in. Mine is 2 seconds because the fade in and pop up is about 2 seconds. Find what works for yours and then hit save and hit save again. Please don't lose your work. You've probably seen people who have a lot of different alerts or a lot of different animations set up, even for just when someone follows. That is done using alert variations, which you can change if you scroll down to the variation sections here. I'm going to show you guys how to set up variations using the bits and subscriber stuff later, because I think it's a better way to learn about variations. But congratulations for now, you've got your follower alert set up and you're a master at the uploading process. The reason I covered followers alone is because they're the easiest to set up. They're not as complicated as subscribers, bits, or donations, which we're going to cover now, and they require a bit more time because there's a few extra settings that you don't need to worry about with followers. For example, if you set up all of the same steps that I just showed you in the follower alert, but you set it up for anything like bits, subscribers, or donations, then you're going to come across a new setting. The first one being text-to-speech, which we're going to set up using bit text-to-speech for now. Why do we need this? Well, viewers love it. Viewers love having a chance to speak, and honestly, it's a staple of Twitch. I really recommend getting this set up when you start out because people really enjoy using it. The first setting you're going to see in the bits section is minimum bits for alert. Now, I have this set to 50, meaning that someone must donate 50 bits for an alert to play on my stream. This just means I'm not going to get someone donating 1 bit over and over and over again and setting off my alert and spamming my stream. I really recommend 50 at a minimum you set this to. 50 bits is only 50 cents USD, so no, you're not being greedy by setting it to that. You're just making it so your content isn't spammed by alerts. That said, in my settings, 50 bits also won't get you text-to-speech because I wanted to add another layer for someone to enjoy. Text-to-speech for me currently is 100 bits, so 1 USD, and I think that's a very fair and a normal price when you're just starting out. To set this, you'll want to open up your text-to-speech settings, click enable, and then set your min bits to read, as I said, to 100 bits. You can change the voice here to whatever you want. My chat absolutely loves Brian. Some people I've seen really like Jeremy, but it kind of freaks me out.
My name is Justin, not Jeremy. Idiot.
My spam security is set to low because my chat is very chill. When it gets a bit rowdy, I will up this. So figure out what works for your chat and then alter this as you go. My volume is set to really just how loud I want the alert sound to play. I have this set to 75% because that fits nicely with my GoXLR and my other microphone settings. Hit save and now you have text-to-speech set up for your bits. You'll need to head over to your donations and your sub settings if you have these and do the same thing as well. With subscriptions, text-to-speech only works when it's a resub, so you'll want to set those up in the resub section. However, they are all the same settings that we just went through. The final step of this section is to check out the raids and hosts section. Now, this one is going to be contentious. I know I'm going to get yelled at for this. I really recommend changing it so that the raid and host alerts don't play for just one person. That means they won't play if one person hosts you with one viewer or raids you with one viewer, aka themselves. Now you might be thinking, why? You can't tell on my stream because I have this turned off, but I get raided and hosted over and over and over again by people all the time, and they only have one viewer. And if the alert doesn't go off, they do it again 6 or 7 more times trying to make their name appear. I can understand doing it once as a little raid, but there's a lot of people trying to spam these to bigger streamers. So set this up for now. Mine is set to 5 people, but if you're streaming to 2-3 viewers, then maybe setting it up so it could be 2-3 viewers works just as well. Figure out what works for your community and go for that. But maybe you want to have different alerts for different bit variations. So 100 bits plays one alert and 200 bits plays a different one. Or maybe when someone gifts 5 subs to you, you don't want to have the alert play 5 times, but instead a special 5 sub alert go off. We're going to cover all that at the end of the video. But first, I want to throw it out there, if this helps you out at all, we have a lot of other tutorials. I want to give a quick highlight to one of my favorite tutorials on the channel, which is how to make any microphone sound better. It's going to be linked in the description and in the cards right now. Seriously, that video I think has the most value out of any video I've ever created. Go check it out if you're a new streamer trying to get your mic to sound good. And then last week we did just release another free animated overlay, which is in our Discord. It's called the Glitch Pack. It goes alongside the other ones as well. So feel free to check those out if you're in need of a new overlay or you're just starting out and want to get something looking nice. Okay, let's keep moving. Now we need to get you set up with variations. Now these can be a little confusing at first, but just bear with me. We're going to get through them. And then I'm going to show you guys how I used bit variations to quadruple my revenue a few months ago. Head over to the bits section, scroll down to where your alert variations are and click open alert variations. You might already have some in here. It's up to you if you want to use these, but they might mess up what we're going to do, so you can hit disable if you want for now. Click add variation with current settings. This will duplicate the alerts that we set up earlier or whichever one you currently have, and it will use the exact same settings. You'll want to name this to be something like 200 bits because this will be our 200 bit alert. I know, complicated, but we'll get there. We need to change the condition of this trigger. You can see it here. This means, obviously, if someone were to do a certain thing, it would trigger this new variation of the alert. I want mine set to bits used is exactly amount. And then the amount below we set 200. You can also set this to is at least, so anything over the amount you set triggers the alert. The rest of the settings are the same as when I showed you earlier. You have your message, your template, your animation, and all your media. You can change this out for whatever you want to play at 200. Then once you're done, hit save again, all the places, please keep saving. I'm so scared you guys are going to lose your work like I have in the past. If you want to set up another variation for your alert, you click duplicate on your variation, and then you change what triggers it, and you change out your media. One thing you'll notice very soon if you're taking all of this channel's advice is you're going to start getting a lot of gift subs probably because you're growing so fast. Well, that means we're going to need to get you set up so that when someone gifts 5, maybe 10 subs to you, it doesn't play the alert 5 or 10 times. It just plays a special 5 sub alert. As usual, back to the Streamlabs website, go to your alert box, subscriber tab, scroll to the very bottom, open the alert variations, new variation, condition, user gifted at least amount subs at once. Amount of gifts set to 2, for example, message template as follows, bracket gifter bracket has gifted bracket amount bracket community subs. This means anyone who gifts over 2, for example, 4 subs, then they will come up and say, person has gifted 4 subs, rather than playing 4 times. I have mine set to brackets so that 2 to 4 will play a certain alert, 5 to 9 will play a different alert, and then 10 plus will play a different alert as well. Congratulations, you're now a master of setting up all of your variations. You can have a play, do whatever you want with it, and kind of get into the nitty gritty. Now I need to show you guys how to increase your revenue. I know I just called you the master, but I'm the wise old man who's failed a lot in his life and he's about to impart some wisdom on you. And before anyone says it, yeah, look, I know I don't have the beard to be a wise old man. Leave me alone. Back in the day, I was earning $20 to $40 dues. That's Australian currency, if you didn't know, per stream. And then I came up with a trick, a small idea that I'd seen other people do, but a new way to implement it that took a certain type of stream that I was doing to bring in $150 dues every single time I went live. Phasmophobia, ladies and gentlemen, if you haven't heard of it, is a ghost hunting game. Now, it doesn't have to be Phasmo, but in this case, that's the one I used. In this game, they have a lot of scary jump scare sound effects, as well as a few other things. And all of these sound effects are completely available for you to grab from the game folder without any troubles. They're high quality, high res, short, snappy, and they're great for alert variations. I set up 9 different alert variations for bits, each one being a different amount of bits between 100 and 109. So 101 did a sound effect, 102 did a sound effect, and you can see where I'm going from there. You might be thinking, a dollar? Really? That's how much you set these alerts to, these jump scares to? That seems a bit cheap. Yes, because that means anyone can do it. Anyone with 100 bits laying around can make me scared, can make me laugh, can make us all have a great time. And that means a lot of people are gonna do it. And when a lot of people put $1 in, it starts to add up very quickly, as well as makes a very fun stream. Now, as I said, you don't have to do this for specific games. The same concept works for if you're gonna reuse old vines, memes, or clips from your own channel that people love. You can set them to 169 bits or 420 bits and have specific jokes that go with them. People love using those. I've seen people who have 69-bit alerts and it's always just some stupid joke and it works great. I'd really recommend spending a lot of time on your alerts and making sure they are engaging, funny, and unique, because they will go a long way to increasing your followers, your subscribers, and your bit donations. Just don't use anything DMCA. Please, for the love of God, don't get a copyright strike because you went and used the entire track of Lady Gaga. Please. I'll see you guys next week. I hope this helped you out. Consider subscribing, liking the video, and comment down below if you need any advice on anything else.